Hi everyone, welcome back to our segment Ask the Dermatologist. Today we'll be discussing all things skin, nail and hair with the dermatologist from Singapore, Dr. Teo Wan Lin from TW Skin.
Hi Pramila, it's a pleasure to be back.
So I understand that you formulated a line of cosmeceuticals with your brother, a pharmaceutical engineer. So what is cosmeceutical all about?
Right, so this is one of my favorite topics, Pramila, so it's great that you're asking about it. Cosmeceuticals essentially are a combination of two words, so pharmaceuticals and cosmetics. Pharmaceuticals, as you know, are basically what physicians would prescribe from their office. So these are usually prescription medications that are formulated in laboratories or in pharmacies and is backed by rigorous research to demonstrate effectiveness for certain diseases. Cosmetics, as we all know, women all over the world for centuries have been applying all forms of moisturizers on their skin and skincare products, which you know, claim to have beautifying properties. In this millennia, I feel that no woman should just be using regular skincare, especially if they're seeing a dermatologist. The reason is because whatever you apply on your skin, it is absorbed. And even for medical dermatology issues such as eczema, psoriasis, dermatologists prescribe topicals, okay, which are creams that are absorbed for treatment of these conditions. And when women start to come to us for cosmetic dermatology concerns such as lasers, chemical peels, injectables, Botox and fillers, I augment the results of these cosmetic procedures using cosmeceuticals. So essentially these are creams which you could apply or cleansers that you use. They have a certain enhancing effect on skin health. They typically are filled with antioxidants. So if you've heard about the process of skin aging, so aging itself is caused by something called free radical generation. So if you are, say, a heavy smoker or you are exposed to a lot of UV rays in your life, you get sunburned constantly or you just, you know, are in an equatorial climate like Singapore, your skin reacts by producing a compound known as free radicals, and that is what causes photo aging. So when you get wrinkles on your lines or you lose volume on your face, all these things are signs of chronological and environmental related aging. So what antioxidants do is that they eat up the free radicals that is a huge component of this aging process and try to kind of keep it at bay.
They actually different from over-the-counter products, because like there are like antioxidant products like serums and things out there. So how are they different from that?
The thing with cosmetics is that they are not regulated either by the FDA or in Singapore the HSA. So essentially, as long as your skincare product or whatever you're selling does not contain banned substances, nobody really checks if they're effective or not. And the difference really is that in a dermatologist's office, when we prescribe something to complement our cosmetic procedures, we would require something which at least is formulated in a laboratory. So in my case, I formulated it together with my brother, who is a pharmaceutical engineer and oversees the measurement of the bioactivity, which is how active the substance is in our skincare to ensure that, you know, there are certain indicators such as absorption, proper penetration, concentration, that is sufficient to deliver the kind of results that we want. And above all, the ingredients that we curated to be in these products are not just, you know, based on what's popular in the beauty industry, or like some miracle serum or mask or sauce. We are always looking at the active ingredients, and these are what we find in public databases like PubMed. So that's a scientific database where you can, you know, easily research whatever active ingredient is being purported as, the latest anti-aging secret. And chances are, if you want to have something which really works, it will be published in a medical paper. I think at the end of the day, it's the most important thing to be discerning. Mm-hmm. So do a lot of brand research. Mm-hmm. I would say going for what your dermatologist mm-hmm. recommends rather than the most fashionable mm-hmm. cosmetic brand out there is probably the most the easiest way to mm-hmm. distinguish between something that would actually help you mm-hmm. and you know, what would just be like a over-the-counter moisturizer.
So wow, Dr. Teo, that was really informative. So remember guys, do your research before putting anything on your skin. That's all for today's section, and we'll see you next week.